because I've been seeing my last one. May 9th. Jeez, just coming up on a month since I painted last. Sheesh. Well, in the meantime, I've been trying to practice up a bit. I've been doing these quick little paintings in this thing. They're not nearly as good as my other paintings. I'm not even going to show you that one because it's awful. But I've been trying to stay at least semi in practice. They're not anywhere close to my actual paintings, I feel like, just because I spent like 10 minutes on them and that's it. But I'm attempting to stay at least somewhat in practice. Now, I started streaming a little before I was ready because I'm still mixing up my paints. Just kind of making sure everything is working still. No surprises. Although I started without paper towels, I should probably go grab some real quick. Be right back. Get this one and the other done within a couple months, but at the speed I'm going, that is not realistic at all. Alright, got my paper towels. Where was I working on last? That'll be a real big question. Which paint is which paint? I think this is the black paint here, and this is the gray. Hard to tell. Really wish I had a dust cover for this thing. Yeesh. I'm gonna start with just light gray. Kinda looking for some shadows that I want to put in. Start to give some of the background some definition. Problem is, I haven't done this in so long. Again, that I'm gonna be having trouble just finding what I was doing before. And last time I was having trouble too, because there was a big break before that, but that's what I get for working, you know, 6-12s a week. That white bit there, it looks like a piece of bark sticking out. It's kind of cool. on a dry, dead and dry brush, trees. In the distance, see these thick brushed forests are never just green. I mean, except in like just past springtime, then they're a bit green or a pretty solid green, but I kind of wish I hadn't done that, but I'll make it work. I like that. That looks pretty good. But this is on the shade side, so maybe I should give it a little more shadows, but not just that slice. Computer's running low on storage. I hope it doesn't cut my stream short. I only just started. On the shade side, the sun's coming from the overhead left side. I like it a lot. Now you're starting to see the definition in that tree. Now I just gotta bring the definition to all the others there. The problem with this one is it's supposed to be just in shadow, so I gotta bring the green down a bit here. I knew there was something wrong with it, but I just couldn't put my finger on it until just now. Also, I need to, well, the green hanging branches from this tree are blocking out this, so I gotta make that obvious somehow. I mean, on top of that, it's just in the shade already. Like when I went over it previously, I went way too dark, way too fast. Which it's not inaccurate, but it somehow doesn't look quite right. The light is at such an angle that I think all the trees are going to be fairly dark too. Get maybe a little bit of sun on this one, just right on that face. Maybe a little bit of sun right here. but the rest of the trees are pretty much going to be shadows. Oh, I still need to go darker with those background spruce trees. Maybe if I just darken them from underneath, it'll give it that pop that I'm looking for. Even though that'd be a little inaccurate. It's my painting. It's in danger of being very overworked. So it's something I hate to do. Nothing worse than overworking painting and it turns all brown. Like this. I feel like I massively overworked this, but it gives it a bit of a, I don't know, I went way too, this is supposed to be in front of all the smoke and dust, so that's why it's so clear, but it takes it out of it, and all the dust is flowing in front of the sun, which is behind the machines there, but you can see how it's overworked it, but in that situation it actually works. Because it's not overworked. Oh, whatever. Gotta go green here before I put in the shadows. I could start putting in the shadows on this after I take a break on the background. Pretty sure I'll have to go over this spruce tree here with a wash of gray because it is just too emeraldy. And while, yeah, sure, some look like that. Just looks unrealistic. Especially if I'm going for like a fantasy style path here, which I am. Let's work some more on the background. I hope that when I'm finished with the background, I can just work on the front without having to come back. That's the way it's supposed to go. It's supposed to. Kinda like that. Splatter of white in this tree. I feel like there's too much. There shouldn't be any white back there, though. I mean, other than on the tree itself, like in between the lines, there shouldn't be white. It's making it way too bright. Well, if it's bright, it's supposed to be bright green or really dark green. These, while I like the tree, it should be a little more weepy. I guess it'll get covered up by the rest of these. There will be a certain point where I'm spending too much time on the background, and I'll just have to push on regardless of if I want to or not. I'm gonna have to take the white out of this guy here. I wanted to add the lightest gray I could there, with kind of splitting the difference, keeping the I went too dark on the left side. That's what happened. I wanted to do a real thin gray wash, but so I'll add some other other colorations to hopefully draw away from that. Pretty quick, I'll have to, well, let's do some real light washes of gray in that area. Which brush do I want? Well, there's some scrap paper. Ah, that's why it's scrap. I think we'll move up the path from there. Thank you. detail on the monitor that I just put a layer of gray over that. Looks like I'll have to go a lot darker probably. So all the path closest to me will be in shadow. And all the plants too. I mean, all this is going to be in shadow, and then you'll just be able to see the brightness out there and above. Well, it might be pretty dark above too, actually. But I think that'll look pretty cool if I pull it off. Should be going like this. Because the shadows are of the branches. So why am I doodling down here when I should be sketching? That might be too dark. I don't know why I didn't think of that earlier. Don't have a ton of practice with shadows and stuff. Listen to this mix so many times, it feels like. Gotta get a new royalty-free mix to add into it or to switch it up with. Glad I noticed what I was doing wrong with the shadows, but man, I wish I'd done it earlier. That's how it goes, though, isn't it? Sunspots would look a lot more realistic if I had gotten the trunks down first. Shadow trunks first. Just haphazard, random, but what are you gonna do? Overworking it. I gotta stop doing that. The grays have got a mesh. They can't be standing out like they are. gotta get practice with shadows, and I gotta practice with greenery, with foliage. Until I do the greenery in the shadows, it just looks like a mess. Start there. Let's do some background greenery and maybe some close-up greenery. Never just work on one thing. I always get bored and gotta do something else. Can't just do a background one day, this tree the next day. Too green. I want yellow green, which is funny because this is supposed to be that, but it separates so easily. Let's see if I can't mix some up. Maybe I'll just have to. See, it's so green. Well, yeah, I mean, you might not be able to tell the camera. It's so much greener than I want it to be. Well, I guess I'm going for dark definition then. Next time, maybe I'll just mix up a new batch. Thank you. part is looking at this paint just in my little tray here. It looks yellow green, but it putting it on the paper, it doesn't. Let's see. That part of the song sounds like Shrek sings in the original movie after the credits or whatever. Karaoke dance party. That's what it sounded like, the tune. The phone is blown up. Alcoholic, coffee-addicted friend has a Guinness with coffee in it, so that's his new diet from now on. If I use some less transparent paint, I'd be able to do this better. But then it would be me. For now. Practice some close-up watercolor. Maybe in my little sketchbook. It's got to get more defined, bigger, and darker. More texture, more definition. Come back over it with some gray and give it some shadows as well. Man, the green really can't overpower that brown, can it? it's the same green, just in a different batch. Quiet dog. Yeah, I'll tell her to quit. Sunlight on a leaf in shadow is weird. First off, I've got to have it. In line with the shadow here. The shadow is going to go like this. Let me just mark it out with the green. It's going to be green eventually anyway. It's something I should do more, if as long as it's not going to mess anything up. I gotta not spend too much time on this right now, because I may come back to it later and decide to change something, so. But for now, I think that's pretty good. Pretty cool. Shadows are too extreme. Hmm. That looks really interesting. I like playing with shadows. And framing. Framing's cool too. But it looks like it's finally coming together to make some sense. Instead of a smattering of little sketch marks. I feel like I should do a little more before I get off. Maybe 6 minutes worth. That'll put me at an hour, even though my old regular was like, what, hour and 22 minutes or something. But I'll try and get on again maybe, what, Sunday at some point. Because as soon as the big old machine I'm working with starts up, 6:12's the only reason I'm home today so early is because it's been down. So I was like, better stream, or at least I better paint, even if no one's watching. I better paint so I can finish this thing. Really hope it turns out good. It's definitely different than, well, anything else I've done. With this bush, it should be bigger, should cover more of the background. The stems should be wilder. Shadowy parts should be shadowier, and the lighter parts should be yellower. Maybe I'm hyper-focusing a little bit. A little bit. Thank you.
do some grass. Nice little grass, friendly little grass stems here.
Put in all this greenery before I the shadows in and just obliterate all the definition. The weird thing will be drawing some Devil's Club in here, and I can see Devil's Club. You know, this is actually supposed to be Devil's Club, not a lily or whatever it is that I painted. Should be, I don't know, 5 or 6 of them. Luckily it's not a Devil's Club forest, because that would be an issue. Sure where I'm going with that yet, but it looks good to me. Oh, my famous bass line. So quiet, I can't believe it. That's what I get for recording on like ghetto equipment. Be something, but it's definitely short. Hour and 5 minutes. Well, let's see. Trying to for a lighter fern with darker background, it wasn't really working out. I guess the next tree to do, well, I guess. Find some more of this yellowish paint for that bush right there. Phone going off again. Do some water. Blending, that's what it's called. You know, I totally neglected this spot. I mean, there's not much to see. I'm gonna mainly have this bush here be in front of that, but in between these two, I think. So you'll still get some light. Jeez, how many texts was that? Crazy guys. Oh, I've been leaning over too long now. My back hurts. It sucks to get old. Remember when I was younger, I could do some weird gaming, you know, marathon. Be scrunched over all day long.
Not even feel it.
Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna stop there. I'm pretty happy with that. I'll leave that little remark there to remind me.
I have to focus on that spot next time.
Alright, well, I can't tell if anyone came by or not, but if you did, thank you. And if you visited afterwards, thank you as well. Hopefully I'll be back on next Sunday, or if I get a surprise early day off at some point, I'll try and get on and paint. And then I've also got Game of Games going on with all the guys, so I think I've got one or two matches of, actually it might be three or four matches of Titanfall one-on-ones left, and then after that I think we're gonna do what is it, Star Wars Squadron Battle, so that ought to be fun. I'll take off now. Have a good evening, everybody.